For over 115 years, there has existed a question. A question that has puzzled scientists, philosophers, and indeed the entire human race ever since its conception. It has become synonymous with cognitive defeat, an unanswerable question, intrinsically imponderable. But today I have solved it. The world can now rest knowing the definitive answer to its greatest question yet. How much wood could a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could chuck wood? Hi, it's me, the Lone Waffle, and I'm here today to not only answer this question once and for all, but to back up my answers with math and science! Back in 1902, this tongue twister came into being and has been recited countless times. In 1957, Associated Press published a statement on the question saying it was, and I quote, "a riddle which beats the Sphinx since it's still unanswered." Well, Associated Press, you can sleep easy now, knowing that this Sphinx-like question is no more. To start formulating an answer, we will have to know a few things first. We will also have to specify what chucking is. Is it eating the wood, or is it actually just literally throwing it around? I'll be solving the question twice based on both of the possible criteria. So let's solve for the woodchuck eating the wood first. Here are the things we need to know. 1. What the heck is a woodchuck? 2. Do they eat wood? If not, what do they eat? 3. Where do they live, and how much do they eat in a day? And 4. How long do they live? Well, number 1 is that's a woodchuck. It's also called a groundhog, thickwood badger, bucky, as I used to call them as a child, and my new favorite name for them, whistle pigs. They live in Canada and Northeast America, primarily in open country on the edges of forest. They are herbivores, and their diet consists of grasses, berries, crops, nuts, and on occasion, to clean and sharpen their teeth, bark, but no wood. They eat about 1.5 pounds of food a day, weigh on average 6 to 12 pounds, and can live for 6 years out in the wild. Using a quick weight-based calorie calculator, I found that an organism weighing 12 pounds needs to ingest 320 calories a day to maintain its weight. Okay, so they don't eat wood. Bummer. That would have made the question a lot easier, but since no one has solved it for 115 years, I guess that would have made humanity look kinda dumb. But we're gonna have to find out what kind of tree it would proverbially chuck if it could, in fact, chuck wood. The question doesn't specify a type of tree, however. It really doesn't need to, because most trees consist of the same stuff and won't affect calorie calculations. Trees are made primarily of one thing, cellulose, or fiber. It's what makes the tree cells rigid and makes trees, like, the best thing to build houses out of. Fiber is one of the harder things for animals and humans to digest, and it's recommended in small daily doses of 28 grams for the average adult. However, this planet seemingly lacks a groundhog-only dietitian, and I couldn't find the recommended intake of fiber for one. This doesn't matter, since I will be basing my calculations off how much wood this little sucker could scarf down in a day in order to receive its 320 calories. Except wood doesn't have any calories. Well, crap. But termites eat wood, and they aren't starving to death, so... how's a termite do it? Termites have this awesome digestive system, which uses a huge array of microbes to turn cellulose into a short-chain fatty acid called acetic acid, which they subsist on. Side note, this process also produces methane gas, and termites are thought to be responsible for 11% of the methane gas in our atmosphere. Oh. So we know there are creatures out there that eat wood and live long, happy lives. Why can't our special groundhog do the same? I mean, the question does ask how much it would chuck if it could chuck. So let's make it able to chuck, and chuck hard. So our little whistle pig now has the proper digestive system for eating wood. Great, how much could it eat in its lifetime? Well, here comes the fun part, molecular processes in the digestive system itself. Given that a molecule of cellulose has a molar mass of 162.1406 grams per mole, methane has a mass of 16.043 grams per mole, and acetic acid molecules have a mass of 60.05 grams per mole, we find that a lot of the mass is lost along the way, and only 37% of the stuff is now usable to our termite hog, the rest being lost as methane or to the fermentative bacteria in its gut. Side note, all the groundhogs on Earth would be super gassy, and if there was enough hogs eating enough wood around the world, they would single-handedly turn Earth into a superheated ball of greenhouse gases, like Venus. So thank God they can't actually chuck wood. We're doing that for them. Anyway, now the groundhog would have to compensate for only getting 37% of that 1.5 pounds of food it eats a day, which is about 0.555 pounds. A little math later, and now our little bro has to eat 2.7027 pounds of tree to get its 1.5 pounds worth of usable food, the rest of which is released as solid waste or just straight up death farts. So now it has its 1.5 pounds worth of food that has been converted to the 320 calories it needs per day. Sweet! We just have to figure out how much wood it would eat in its 6-year lifetime. Taking 2.7027 and multiplying it by 365 gives us how much it would eat in a year, multiply that by 6, and you get how much it would chuck, could chuck in its lifetime, which is... 5,918.913 pounds. Or like, 3 normal-sized trees. Huh. That's actually quite a bit, considering the average American adult eats nearly 2,000 pounds of food a year, eating only twice as much as our woodchuck. Impressive, but certainly not astronomical. Well, I guess there it is. If a woodchuck could chuck wood, it would chuck 5,919 pounds before keeling over dead due to horrific ulcers from literally turning wood into vinegar its whole life and having severe abdominal pain from an excess of fiber. Oh wait, I forgot about the other part of the equation. What if chucking meant moving wood? I mean, it could also mean regurgitating, but that would just be the same answer as before, except now the woodchuck would spend all of its time in the high school bathroom with a feather. But how can we figure out how much it can move? What does that even mean? Are we calculating for length of space the wood is being moved, or how heavy a piece of wood it could carry? Okay, let's say that our woodchuck no longer has that super cool digestive system, and can now eat all the veg its heart desires. It's still 320 calories that need to be added in order to keep the critter's weight the same on a daily basis. So let's say our woodchuck does about 320 calories worth of moving wood around every day. For simplicity's sake, I've created this example. The groundhog has two stacks of 8-pound logs that it will drag back and forth between the two, completing a trip every 30 seconds. Putting some info into an exercise calculator with the weight of the groundhog being the maximum 12 pounds and the weight lifted being 8 pounds for an hour gives a calories burn number of 43.44. Divide 320, its daily calorie intake, by our number and you get 7.366, or the amount of trips it would be able to make in a day. Multiply 7.366 by 8, the amount of pounds each log weighs, and you get 58.93, or the amount of pounds it would be able to move in a day. Multiply that by 365, and then again by 6, gives the number it would be able to move in its entire lifetime, which is 129,052 pounds. That may not seem like a big number to us, but to a groundhog, that's gigantic. So now if anyone ever asks you how much wood could a woodchuck chuck, if a woodchuck could chuck wood, you can answer like this: 5,919 pounds if it's eating it, and about 129,052 pounds if it's lifting it. Thank you guys so much for watching. This was a metric ton of fun to research. I haven't ever done anything like this, and I haven't had to worry about math in a few years, so this was a bit of a challenge. But there you have it, the answer, after 115 years. Thank you all so much for watching. It really means a ton to me. And I will see you in the next one. Doodles. Back in 1902, this tongue twister, even tongue twister is a tongue twister. God damn, English. Well, Associated Press, you can sleep easy now, knowing that the Sphinx, that's because we're making life easier. How much wood could a woodchuck? It's a tongue twister. It's the easiest one. They live in Canada and Northeast America, primarily. However, this planet seemingly lacks a ground hold ongly.